day in July of this year, from the 11th to the 21st of July, we have 14 people going to Africa. 10 young people and 4 leaders. Absolutely. And you're going to get a sense of what they do. So over here, this is starting to build a house at the bottom left, the house there. And then that's putting a window in. And then this is the finished product of the house. And this is Paul Window playing with some children. We run a holiday club like every day, every afternoon for the children in the township. And it's amazing. When we did it the first year, we started on having about 20 kids on day one. By day 5, I think we had about 100 or so. Last year, the trip last year that we didn't go on, I think they had about 250 plus children that came to the holiday club. And it's amazing. It's just such a privilege. And so I want you to give a huge round of applause. Most of them are here this morning. They've come especially for both services so that you can see their lovely, beautiful faces, for both the leaders and the young people who are going to do Rebuild 2014. Give it up for them. Come on up, guys. Come on up. Come. Keep those applause coming. So they're nearly all here. We've got 3 or 4 that just can't make it. We'll just kind of go down the line. And your name is?
Craig.
Correct. Very good. Well done. So now, Craig, you've done this before?
Yeah, I went on the first trip to Africa, and absolutely amazing, amazing trip, life-changing trip, and so privileged to be on it again.
Great, fantastic. So I'm going to go down the line quickly, what your name is, why you want to do the trip, okay? Just so everyone can hear it, just make something up, even if, like, Matt made me come, anything will do, fine. Your name is?
Amanda. I'm going because Craig said it was good.
Yeah,
new to us, great challenge, and getting to know youth and looking forward to it.
Awesome. Amanda and Simon and the lovely Middle Ditch family, which is, this is Rebecca here, and Silent University, again, recently joined our church. We're so blessed to have them. They're a fantastic family. So you are?
Rebecca.
And why are you doing Rebuild, Rebecca?
The experience. House.
Storefront. Yeah. Can you think, you know, guys, I'm a DIY disaster, you know that, don't you? And I've built 3 houses. Get me. Come on. You know, follow my wake. I'm not doing this trip though. And I broke a nail last time. That was it. I'm not doing it again. Okay.
I'm Jade.
You are Jade. Good to see you, Jade. And why are you doing Rebuild?
I think it sounds like a good way to do something for someone else. I mean, there's always like opportunity to do volunteering around here, but actually going to a different country and be a bit of a culture shock as well, which I think will be really good. So, sounds great.
Awesome. And you are?
Charlie, and I think it would be good because it would be a life experience and it would be good to help other people.
Fantastic. Good man. Well done, Charlie.
I'm Joshua.
Woohoo! I mean, woohoo all of you guys. I don't want you to feel that was a special woohoo for Joshua. Okay, Joshua, why are you going to Rebuild?
I feel like it'll be a life-changing experience and it'll really get me to see other people's view and how they actually live life.
Fantastic. Well done, mate. And then we have here...
Hi, I'm Alistair. I think it'll be really interesting and good experience to have. And yeah,
that's great, Alistair. Brilliant. Well done. And here we have
Teo.
Doing it to support others and yeah, just a life-changing experience.
Awesome. Excellent. And you are?
I'm Will.
Well, hey.
And I think it's great to be able to change people's lives and change your own life. And great to be part of.
Well done. Excellent.
I'm Dan. I'm going because I need to make a difference. And now that Matt's ducked out, somebody's got to be stupid enough to take this lot overseas for 10 days. And, well, mug written across it.
And Lauren, this will be your 4th Rebuild trip, won't it? Because you've done all the other 3. So why are you going back? You've done it so many times.
Because I'm a glutton for punishment. And... seriously, it is an awesome experience. These guys, they completely change a life for a family over there who wouldn't know what it was to have a home. And it is, as a leader, it's an absolute privilege to watch the 10 young people who got this going this year, or the 51 we've had previously, actually go out, step out in faith, do something challenging, do something new, and actually learn something about themselves and transform their lives and someone else's.
It's brilliant, isn't it? Fantastic.
I was just it's not that we can't count. We are taking 10 young people, and some of them aren't here. We're not that. Don't get worried.
We
can
lost
count.
Them already.
All right.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just need to reassure people.
Absolutely. Yeah. 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 We can't even get up to church, let alone go to get South Africa. That's worrying, isn't it? And so, listen. 2 things just before we let these guys go. So isn't it great? Isn't it absolutely great? So it is great, and because it's so great, church, we need your help, okay? We absolutely need your help, because here's the challenge, because we go in 6 months' time. We have £21,000 to raise in 6 months in order to make this trip happen. And so what we're endeavouring to commit is that corporately, both individually and as a church, everyone here has to raise £1,500 for the trip, which covers everything from getting there to all the materials and all that stuff. And so we want to try and work together, to raise at least £500 per person. So individually, these guys have got about £1,000 each to raise. And so I'm ideally looking for about 30 or so people who would be willing either to do some kind of sponsored activity or maybe just make a gift of around £200. If we do that, then we'll be home and dry for the target. So there might be some people here who might think, actually, I'll just give and support these guys to whatever level, as generous as you can. That'd be brilliant. But the most effective way is if lots of people do little fundraising things. On the last trip we did to Mexico, we had Tom Kemba, I think Paul Reynard, and a bunch of people. They did a bike ride from Brighton to Paris. Hitchin to Paris, that's even more hardcore, from Hitchin to Paris, and literally raised thousands of pounds through doing that, because some of Tom's workmates joined in and they all raised funds for this trip. It's that kind of thing. So we really need help to do this. And even if you can, you know, part with £10 or whatever you could do, we want to get behind these guys. For some, it's really financially challenging to be able to do the fundraising stuff. Some of us are much better networked than others. And so is that okay? Can I throw that out to you, that you will really think about that? And we will keep this on the agenda. There will be some things happening, fundraising events that we'd love you to support. But this is a huge step of faith to raise £21,000 in 6 months. We've done it before. We had to raise £48,000 the first year we went. So we've done it before. We know that God will do it again. And you know the witness it will be for these guys, for God to come through with the finances, because some of them, understandably, are pretty terrified. Like me. Let's stand. We're going to pray for them. Then the moon breaks. She takes the corner. That's awesome.